Hi everyone, I am going to do a quick walkthrough of your sandbox assignment for this week, which is creating an accessible homepage in your sandbox. All right, so I'm going to take it step by step. I am in my own sandbox, and this is what your homepage should look like. It's the default homepage in your sandbox. The first thing we want you to do is edit the page. Click the edit button and just go ahead and delete everything that's on there. We're going to start fresh. And we want you to enter some information. It's in the assignment instructions, but basically, you need your course name somewhere on there. So I'm going to say, Welcome to Library 10, which is my course name. And you want to do some kind of description. And you wrote this in a previous assignment. So you can paste in the description that you wrote for the last assignment. And then you need a section on how to get started, right? So your homepage should direct your students on how to get started, at least during the first week of class. So I'm going to paste in some text about how I prefer that my students get started with my course. And then we want you to add some information about yourself. So your name, your preferred contact method, your response time, and any other really important information to know about you. So this can be done in a variety of ways, but here's one way to achieve the assignment. So after we have our text on the page, we need to format this for accessibility using the guidelines from the module. So we would like you to format your headers. So you're going to find on your page anywhere where there is a natural header. And you're going to use the paragraph menu on the rich content editor here. So we click paragraph and we say header two. Your first headers are always going to be header two in Canvas. Okay, so you're going to go through and do header two on anything that looks like a header. Done. Easy, right? Okay, next we would like you to try making a list, an accessible list. So anything that looks like it should be a list, maybe my contact methods, right? I can highlight it and I can use the bullets or the numbered list on the editor. And this looks like a bulleted list to me because it's not in any kind of order. And if you see this happening where it doesn't grab bullets, it's easy. I can either backspace and hit enter like this, or I can clear my formatting and start again. Super easy to fix, but you basically want to see those bullets from the list here. And then we also want you to try inserting a link, right? So let's try inserting a link to an external site. Like in my case, I have a link to the library on my homepage. So I can just highlight the text, Cabrillo College Library, and I can either click insert link on the editor, or I can click Control K on my keyboard, and I believe that's Command K for a Mac. And I can paste in the link and set it to open in a new window. And look how that looks. So it's a meaningful link, right? The text is the link. Another thing you might do is add a link to an internal page in your Canvas course. So contact me using the inbox or Q&A discussion. Maybe you have a Q&A discussion for them to use. So if I click highlight again, highlight the words you want to link to. And if I come over here on the right-hand side, I can access my discussions. There's my Q&A, and I can just click on it. And voila, there it is. And last thing, an image. So let's say I want to insert an image of myself or something that represents my class. There's my cursor. I can use the images menu on the right-hand side, or I can try using this embed image link, which gives you a variety of other options. Give them a try, see what you like. I personally like images. I can search Flickr for one, or I can upload something that I have in Canvas or on my desktop. So I'm going to use a picture of myself for this example. And there it is. I need to add the alt text and probably make this smaller. Okay, so I'm going to highlight it and click embed image and Here is the alt text. Look at the default alt text. You learned about this in the module. It has it as a file name, which is not useful. I'm going to change that. Aloha in her office at the library with colorful children's art. Okay, and then I'm going to make it much smaller. Don't need a huge picture of myself. Okay, and I'll click save. And there is my beautiful, accessible homepage with the basic information. So that's what we want you to try this week. And you can let us know if you have any questions. Good luck.